This is Cuba, and I'm gonna swim all the way to Florida. But I would have to survive 100 miles of deadly jellyfish, paralyzing Portuguese man of war, raging hurricanes in the distance, and a gang of hungry sharks if I wanted to be the first man in the world to complete this swim. And if I succeed, I'll finally get slapped in the face with a giant fish, but if I fail, I'll get Sparta kicked off a bridge.
Behind me you can see what I presume to be Hurricane Sally, dastardly hurricane born out of the inception of evil. I'm out here having a reasonably good time. My cardio though, however, is severely lacking and things are looking a bit dire. Wish me luck.
And with my luck, the boat I paid to trail behind me had its engine explode, forcing us to halt my journey mid-swim and pray to Poseidon that the situation would resolve itself.
We swam roughly 3 miles out here in only 3 hours. Chances of us actually finishing the swim are looking pretty deplorable at the moment. Some eerie sounds in the distance. Definitely a premonition of something bad to happen, I predict. We have 98 miles to go.
I think if we keep pressing on, we can make it if the jellyfish don't get you first.
But of course, it got worse. After narrowly repairing the boat's engine just in the nick of time, I began my swim anew, plunging myself into unknown waters the following day, only to find myself in the den of jellyfish. Utopian breeding ground for some of the world's most beautiful luminescent jellyfish, but of course, a common place to find yourself stung in the bum by a wandering jelly when you least expect it.
Alright, I'm not saying I'm spooked, but those waters are a bit sketchy.
No lie.
If I were to have gotten stung by one of those, what would the game plan have been?
I've got an EpiPen here, we can break it out, stab it,
your leg.
Just like the movies. Pull this off and then you just like, whack! You just pull the top.
Who's messing around with jellyfish on a day-to-day basis?
Only you. And also, we've got another device here, it's called an e-burp. It'll send out a signal and Coast Guard will come. If it happens and we're real close to Cuba.
While seemingly harmless creatures, if you pet them on the top of their squishy heads, if you happen to accidentally make a sliver of physical contact, the tentacle of a bog jellyfish, you might as well be dead, or so I thought.
All right, Captain, squeeze its tentacles. Jellyfish. There's literally a jellyfish right there.
There's a good chance you're gonna need the EpiPen.
Armed with an arguably futile defense mechanism to survive the crippling sting of the famously incapacitating box jelly, the premonition of a dire future slowly but surely encroached into the deepest recesses of my mind, as one of my greatest fears had manifested itself before my very eyes. Yes, I feared life itself. I was not alone in this ocean. In fact, I was an unwelcome guest in one of the few places on planet Earth who have escaped the all-knowing grasp of science. Sure, I could casually plow forth toward a school of innocuous fish and test my luck by engaging in a staring contest with my local barracuda. But if anything went wrong in this alien world, I would be at the mercy of the Cuban government and was 100 miles estranged from the closest hint of American soil. My existence was held hostage by the whims of fate itself, leaving me no other choice but to... That's right.
Come on, Taylor, let's go! I'm exhausted!
Come on!
Jellyfish away, thank you!
Yet, as a slave to my own dreams, I doggy paddled forward like the filthy animal I was until the limitations of my own mortality melted my wings and I descended into the realm of common man. I was, no joke, really thirsty.
Got any water? I need to chill for a sec.
All right, take this.
Thank you. We got any liquid out here or what?
Yeah, I got you.
You're that little Tyler this today.
Knock up Coke?
Check cola.
Actually pretty good, surprisingly.
My captain, graced with the experience of 10 voyages across the seven seas, all the way to Cuba, had, alas, tasted the bitterness of my bad luck, struck with a statistical anomaly in which myself, my captain's crew, and my cameraman had nearly been taken into custody by the Cuban federales.
You guys have no idea how much work we put into this video. We literally almost got abducted by Cuban coast guards after we sailed over 2 days to Cuba. Right, Captain?
It's been a challenge the whole way. I mean, we go to take off, Hurricane Sally hits. We had to wait out that storm. We spent 2 days, day and night, sailing to Cuba. We're pulling in, and all of a sudden, a little blue light in the distance, and I'm like, I think we got a problem here. Talk to me in Spanish. I'm like, does anybody speak English? No, Spanish only. I'm like throwing stuff at my buddy here.
I was terrified inside. I just didn't want to show it. I thought I was going to get abducted by Cubans and thrown in jail and never see my family again. There was like 6 to 7 guys shining bright lights, and I'm pretty sure they were loaded with guns.
We're within 3 miles of Havana's beach where Tyler could have jumped out and started to swim.
They booted us right when we were this close.
You guys got any food over there?
I got a bagel.
What is this?
They're swarming you.
Oh my God. They're everywhere. It's my bagel, you clowns. These fish are ravenous. Yo, they actually ate the bagel in like 5 seconds. I'm gonna try some backstroke for now.
At this point, each hand that stroked the water wasn't about setting a world record. It was about spitting a fat loogie in the face of fate itself. You think I'm exaggerating? Well, listen to this. A man, within miles reach of where I was currently in the water, learned that day that he was no longer a human, but a tasty appetizer to the whimsical diet of a savage bull shark who, quite frankly, didn't give an F and chomped off this dude's entire shoulder just because it could. I was testing my luck with prehistoric monsters that existed when yo mama was so old, she looked like this. But when all hope was lost, the speed of the water's current drastically shifted, roughly 2.76 knots per hour, allowing me to travel roughly 18 miles over the course of the next 5 to 6 hours.
These freaking animals in the water swim 12 miles. I think the waves right now are probably 2 to 4 foot seas.
A pretty rough swimming out there. Yeah.
So there was a point there where I was really hovering close to Tyler. He's just barely chugging along, and to me it looked like easy prey for a shark. Sharks look for the easy prey.
You don't see people just day swimming out here. That's just crazy.
My neck's being brutally chafed right now. Look at that. My ball sack's even worse, I'm sure. My left nipple, for whatever reason, is getting brutalized out here. Being in the water for a prolonged period of time really sucks the water out of you, ironically enough. All the salt water wants my moisture. I've seen some very sketchy, odd, luminous, sparkly creatures beneath me. I didn't know what they were exactly, so I just zoomed right past them. I'm gonna scarf this down, recharge. One jellyfish sting from a box jellyfish or a Portuguese man of war could be the end of my journey right here, right now.
I soon began to experience a phenomenon known as thalassophobia, the fear of the open waters, which is, apparently, extremely common. Existing in this deep blue ocean for days on end instigates this foreboding sense of dread in which you begin to think that something will attack you underwater and when you least expect it.
Oh, I need some water. I'm dying out here. Please, water. These waves are blowing me in this omnidirectional, haphazard manner. I have no control over which way I'm swimming. I'm strapped with this watch to calculate the amount of miles I'm swimming, these goggles to protect my eyes, these flippers to increase my swim speed, an anti-shark bracelet on my ankle to emit electromagnetic frequencies to deter sharks from my periphery.
But alas, as I'd spent a total of 2 days sailing to Cuba, another 2 days of swimming, and would have another day's voyage back to land, I'd finally, officially, failed, allowing Diana Nyad, the only woman to have ever successfully made this swim, officially keep her world record.
And since I failed, here's my punishment. Hit me, Nick. Oh. Okay. Oh. And.
I wonder if I could swim across the entire Pacific Ocean.